Hello friends, we are discussing our module 2, that is ecology. Today our topic of discussion is food chain versus food web. In this video we will totally discuss a comparative view between food chain and food web. So let us start with food chain first. The food chain is the transfer of energy from photosynthetic source through a series of consumers. As you can see in this diagram, so many creatures are there. There will be transfer of energy from photosynthetic source through a series of consumers. This is the photosynthetic source, green plants or the producers or the autotrophs, you can say, green grass. These are the photosynthetic source, and from grasshopper, this one is the primary consumer. There will be a series of consumers. So primary consumers, secondary consumers, tertiary consumers and top consumers, then decomposers, then finally they will also get converted into help in the formation of green plants. So this food chain here, you can see easily there will be transfer of energy. And how much energy is transferred? I will tell you in later. Okay. Basically, 10% energy is transferred from one trophic level to next trophic level. I will discuss in detail later, after this slide. So, there will be linear flow of energy and minerals. Always, there will be linear flow from one to next, then next, primary, secondary, tertiary. And energy flows from lower to higher trophic levels. Always, energy will flow from lower trophic level to higher trophic level. Never from higher to lower. It always goes upside from bottom to top. Means primary consumers, they are lower trophic level, they are present at lower trophic level, and then these are the apex predator, or you can say top consumers. Only 4 to 5 trophic levels are present in a food chain. 1, 2, 3 or 4 or maximum 5. Energy transfer efficiency limits food chain length. How much efficient that particular trophic level is. Means energy transfer efficiency limits food chain length. Okay. So in this flow chart, you can easily see how much energy is transferred. As I already told you, how much energy is transferred from one trophic level to another. Only 10% energy is transferred. So in this flow diagram, you can easily understand only 10% energy is going from producers to primary consumer, then secondary consumer, then tertiary consumer. Energy lost as heat. The question is where the 90% energy goes. If only 10% energy is transferred from one trophic level to another trophic level, then where this 90% goes? So this 90% energy goes, there will be loss of energy mainly as heat as we proceed from one trophic level to next trophic level. Some energy is lost in the form of heat, waste materials and uneaten parts. And the transfer of energy through the food chain of an ecosystem is known as energy flow. What actually is energy flow? This is the transfer of energy through the food chain of an ecosystem. Okay, here producer, suppose 50 kilojoule energy is going to the primary consumer. So 50 kilojoule, its 10% will be only 50. Okay, so remaining, what about 450? This energy is lost. Then 75 kilojoule, next trophic level pe on transfer, it will transfer on next trophic level and then to the tertiary consumers. Yes, this slide is very much useful, as this will give you how many types of food chain are there. Two types of food chain are there, grazing or detritus food chain. Okay, in grazing type of food chain, it starts from leaves, green leaves or cabbage. These are eaten by caterpillar and they are eaten by thrush. So, transfer of energy starts from producers only. Okay, less energy flows through this. Very much less energy flows from one trophic level to another trophic level. This is the grazing food chain. In aquatic ecosystem, it is a major conduit for energy transfer. So, detritus food chain, what basically detritus means? Dead organic matter. Okay, transfer of energy starts from detritus or decomposing organic material. In this food chain, more energy will flow from one trophic level to another trophic level. In the terrestrial ecosystem, it is the major conduit. So, you can say terrestrial ecosystem, food chain basically it follows detritus. And what about aquatic? That is the grazing. Yes. This slide is all about grazing food chain. One which goes from green plant to grazing herbivores and finally to consumers. This is the primary producers or primary, these are the producers or you can say photosynthetic body. You can say autotrophs. So only 10% energy, photosynthesizers you can also say. So, here you can see 10% energy is transferred to the primary consumers. Okay. And then next, secondary consumers 10% and then tertiary 10%. Okay. These are the herbivores and these are the carnivores. This is the all about detritus food chain. One which goes from dead organic matter to microorganism and then to detritus feeding organism. This is the detritus, primary detritus feeder and secondary detritus feeder. Now, our topic of discussion is food web. That was all about food chain. So, food web basically you can say interconnection between the two organisms. It is a system of interlocking and interdependent food chain. When so many food chains are interconnected, they form food web. In this diagram, you can easily understand, starting from the green plants, as you all know, they are the autotrophs or the photosynthesizer. So, goat, they can also depend on green plants, rabbit also and mouse. Okay, and goat, then jackal and then lion, and here rabbit, then wildcat and then mouse, owl or mouse, snake or kite. Means they are the interdependent or they are interconnected. Food chain is always linear, but food web will be not linear. It may be complex or it may be interlocked or interdependent. This diagram is all about food chain. As you can see, green plants, deer, lion. These are animated pictures. You can easily understand and interesting too. And this is the food web. Again, interconnections or interlocking. Yes, this is too much important content. Food chain follows a single path as animals eat each other. The sun provides food for grass. Grass is eaten by grasshopper. Grasshopper eaten by frog. Frog eaten by snake and snake by hawk. In food web, they show how plants and animals are interconnected. In one line, you can say food web, they are related to interconnection. And food chain, they are related to animals as a single path. They eat each other. Okay. Tree produce acorn which act as food for many mice and insect because there are many mice, vessels and snake have food. Insect and acorns also attract birds, skunks and opossums. With the skunks, opossums, weasels and mice around hawks, foxes and owls can find food. They are all connected like a spider web. If one part is removed, it can affect the whole web. So, food web show how plant and animal are connected in many ways to help them all survive. Food chain follow just one path, single path or linear flow of energy as animals find food. Okay, so this is very important content. So, at the end of this video, friends, I want to ask one thing. Earlier, I was giving my videos or all my classes on whiteboard. Now, I have started my second module, that is ecology videos. I am giving through PowerPoint presentation. So, I want to tell about your views, how you people are feeling through this PowerPoint presentation. You are feeling better in that condition through means whiteboard, or you are feeling more convenient through PowerPoint presentation. So, friends, I want to know. Your comment is very precious for me. So, just write your feelings or your views, how these videos are helpful to you. Means these PowerPoint presentation are more useful, or through whiteboard you can easily understand. Friends, please write your comments in my comment box. I will feel pleasure. Thank you. Please subscribe my channel. Share my video with your friends, colleagues. Thank you once again.